is an arbitrary function. Okay. So far it is a train system is going to be a temporary function. Okay. Any questions about this? I mean that well, gate invariants and the two equations are consistent with each other. For example, this one can be seen as the Jenkins identity for this equation. And if you apply D to this equation, you get again consistent with itself and so on. So it's a self-consistent nonlinear system of equations with a gate symmetry. Okay. Now, it's not at all clear at this point that it is described by a thin field, of course, so we still have to do some work. Yes. Yes. So far, it's arbitrary. Yes. That can be any function of this or kappa, and this would be a system of gate invariants and self-consistent nonlinear equations. Describing the dynamics of this matter field, we don't know yet why it is related to higher spin. Well, we have a hint because we started from something which was a way to encode higher spin fields into one form, and then we enlarge and then until we reach the system. But you have to do some work to show that there are higher spin fields inside. Yes. There is no proof, but it seems that, well, I think there is no proof, but within, if you want to write down an equation which has here curvature of A equal to something, then there's something here to be some form, and basically from the knowledge of what you should get in linearized equation, you see that these two forms should only be in the auxiliary space, and the filter definitions allow to throw away terms which involve Z and Z bar, and so on. There is no proof, but within this framework, it seems that the structure is quite clear. Well, what would you name it? So first, you suppose these are equations that will solve them, and then once you have some solutions, you can resolve the physics by projecting to Z and Z bar equal to this. So by itself, you wouldn't know how to do it. These are products that involve Jordan integral, so you just do some perturbation theorem and simple solution, then you know how to do it. We will do that in the next level. Okay. Before we do that, okay, let me write down here. Let me write down here a less condensed form of the equation. Useful to see at least once. So that's very compact. We can expand it a little bit in terms of W and S. So the equations look like this. There's one important feature that in terms of W, these equations, say that W is flat. And then you get all the other equations. It's a simple exercise to just get this from that trivial. But I'm writing them in this form because I will need them for linearized analysis. Okay. Okay, so these are equivalent, I just written them. Okay, so there is one feature of these equations that you may be surprised about, that they are first order in derivatives with respect to space-time. There is only the x, right? There is no second derivative. But we know at the end of the day we are supposed to describe the propagation of some field with a second derivative kinetic operator, right? So this is a feature of this formalism of Basilius, which is called an unfolded formulation, technically. It just means that you write down a system of dynamical equations in terms of just first order equations, but introducing a lot of auxiliary fields. And the second order equations will arrive after you eliminate those auxiliary fields. So just to give you an idea of how this works in a toy model, in a much simplified example, so that you understand how it works, let's open the parentheses and describe the Klein-Gordon equation in flat space in a similar way, in this unfolded formulation where you have a first order differential operator only. This is almost trivial, but let's illustrate some points. So, suppose we take matchless Klein-Gordon in flat space. We want to rewrite it in a form which is of this type, where we only have a first order differential operator, but some power of auxiliary fields. So, we do something similar to what we're doing there. Let's introduce some master form, well, master field, the function of x and some internal variable y. So, that's still will have an expansion. Now I'm assuming that white would be not the crystal light but vectors. If I have an expansion like this, we have a 1 over tutorial here. And this tells me how many powers of y come along with this, and these are functions of x. Okay, so I'm just writing down some generating functions, okay? And then I explain what's a reciprocal plane, that the Klein-Gordon equations are equivalent in terms of this, are equivalent to the following system. So there is one dynamical equation which has one derivative with respect to x, and one constraint equation which doesn't have x derivative. So this constraint means that this component are traces. Because if you take this, you will get a data minion here, which get a trace. So this constraint just means that I will be traceless stuff, and that this is my equation. So showing that this is equivalent to Klein-Gordon is very simple, and we'll probably already see it. But let's do it.